My name is Lisa Ferrario, and I have osteogenesis imperfecta, or brittle bones, and I have used a wheelchair all of my life. That doesn't stop me from doing the things that I love, being a wife, mother, daughter, sister, friend, and a great cook. The most important thing to me is my family and friends and the community that we have created. We celebrate life and entertain a lot. We have many dinners and parties, and all of them revolve around food and love. I hope you can use some of these recipes to do the same with your family. Hey everybody, today I have Emily as my special guest. Emily is one of my very best friends. How long have we known each other, Emily?
Well, we've known each other for maybe 16 years, but we've been really good friends for about 7 to 8.
Right. And Emily is married to Scott. Stacy's my other good best friend, her brother. So, and that was how long ago now?
It'll be 4 years.
Wow,
in September.
Seems like 50, but okay. 4 years, she's saying. And what was awesome is that Emily asked Anisi to be the flower girl in their wedding. And that was so beautiful. They both looked so beautiful. That's my very favorite picture of Emily and Anisi, and one of my favorite pictures in general. But, okay, so Emily has Emily's famous Nutella mousse trifle. That is the dessert that everyone loves, and we always ask Emily to bring it to whatever occasion we have, right?
Yep.
She brings it a lot. So we're gonna show you that because Chris loves it and wants to eat it, and I know Christina, one of my friends, wanted something chocolate, so this is it. So what you do is first you have a chocolate cake, any chocolate cake mix that you like, or any chocolate cake from scratch, or you can buy one, because basically you're gonna be cutting it up, right, Emily?
Yep.
And putting it in the trifle dish. Yep. When we assemble it, we'll show you that. So we just chose one that we have sometimes used, any chocolate cake. And then what's really cool is Emily's gonna show us how to make this Nutella mousse. Nutella, I love, and we could just eat it by the spoonful. But, and then it involves strawberry. You can use any fruit. Can you use anything?
Like, yeah, I've used raspberries before.
Ooh, that's good, right. So any fruit, but we're gonna do strawberries today. So the first step is to make the cake so we can get it in there. And then while that bakes, we'll do the mousse, okay? So we'll get started on the cake.
All right.
Eggs are in. Emily, you're laughing at the eggs.
I can't crack eggs.
These are farm fresh eggs that Emily gets for us. She got us some last week, so that was super cool. And then digging through the garbage is part of the process. Picking up the eggshell on the floor.
And cleaning up my mess.
And cleaning up messes.
All right, I'm gonna put the cake in the pan, and you can actually use whatever kind of pan you want. You can use round or square, because you're just gonna cut that up when you assemble the actual trifle.
Right.
Look at that chocolatey goodness.
Yum, it looks delicious. And who's gonna lick the bowl? Because Anisi's still sleeping. Teresa might call dibs on that one.
All right, so I'm gonna make the Nutella half of the Nutella mousse part. So I'm going to put in 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter, 5 tablespoons of water. And then 1 cup, you can see this is a heaping cup because I like extra Nutella
heaping.
In that. So sometimes I just eyeball it and put more than a cup or maybe a container full. And this is going into a double boiler. This is my makeshift double boiler.
Right, and it's a double boiler, Emily. Emily does double boilers. Let me tell you, I would never ever do a double boiler because I'm scared of it. And I'm lazy. I do it in the microwave. Do you think the microwave would work, Emily?
I'm not sure about that. I've always just done the recipe as is.
Like, followed the rules, Emily? Are you a rule follower? Yeah. You are. She's a rule follower.
But basically, a double boiler is just a pan with about a couple inches of water in it, and then a bowl on top. I usually use a glass bowl, but you can also use a metal bowl.
Okay.
And so then it's not direct heat, it's indirect heat to melt all this chocolate butter goodness together. All
right. Oh, and there it went out of the pan.
You just have to be careful stirring it.
Right.
Don't make a mess.
So how long does it take to do that, do you think?
Just a few minutes. You want it to get incorporated with the water, the Nutella kind of gets like a grainy texture, but as it melts, it gets nice and smooth. And you just want the butter to be all melted and incorporated as well. So it's best to use softened butter when you use it. All right, it looks like everything has been incorporated and it's nice and smooth. So we're gonna turn that heat off. And then we are going to do the cream part of the mousse. All right, so now I'm just going to pour in some heavy whipping cream as it makes noise going into it. And it calls for 1.5 cups, but I usually use just the one pint. Okay. I like extra mousse. Extra is always better.
Right, especially with this.
So you're basically just gonna beat this until it gets pretty thick, like whipped cream.
Okay.
Alright, so that looks like it's pretty whipped up. It's got some stiff peaks in there. So it looks like whipped cream.
Alrighty.
Alright, so now we're going to incorporate the whipped cream with the Nutella mixture that we made. So I'm going to take my spatula and I'm going to fold it in. So I'm going to take about a third to maybe about half of the whipped cream. Place it into another mixing bowl. Because if you put all of it in with that warm Nutella, it's going to melt that cream right away and it won't actually make it into a mousse. It'll actually make it just some runny soup.
Right.
Which that won't be good.
Right. Well, you never know though, but yeah.
I might taste good.
Right.
You want to make sure you fold it instead of stirring it, otherwise it's not going to keep the mousse consistency. Okay. Look at that chocolate cake.
Yum, looks good. So now is it time for assembling, Emily?
Actually, not quite yet. You want your cake to be cool so then you can cut it up.
Okay.
And then you want to chill the mousse for a little bit so it gets a little bit thicker. With that butter, it's going to thicken up a little bit.
Okay, so we have to wait. Okay. Okay, we are ready to assemble. Everything's done.
Yep.
The chocolate cake is done and we've cut it up into little small pieces. And the mousse is done. Look at that. Looking good. And I'm actually gonna go ahead and taste it just to make sure it's okay for us later. God, there's nothing better than Nutella. Holy crap. Okay. So So Emily, show us how the first
part
goes. All right,
so you're going to layer it by cake, mousse, strawberry. So I always think cake, mousse, strawberry.
Okay. That's like a little song. Cake, mousse, strawberry.
So you're just going to put it around the trifle container.
Okay, that looks nice.
And you can actually use any clear glass container just so you can show what it looks like.
Pearl, are you watching? Are you saying, what was the song, Emily?
Cake, mousse, strawberry.
Pearl, cake, mousse, strawberry. She's back here waiting for a strawberry. She likes strawberries.
All right, so the bottom is covered with cake.
Okay.
And then we're just going to do a layer of that mousse. You want to kind of make sure you push it to the edges so then when you put the strawberries in, it looks pretty.
Sometimes you have extra mousse, right, left over?
Yes.
And what else can you do with this mousse?
Like you can just dip your strawberries in it, any kind of fruit, cookies. I know that you filled cannolis
right
with that mousse.
Right, one of our good friends, Billy, makes pizzelles and they are so fantastic. And if you roll them a little bit and fill them with this, they're great.
All right, so then we just have a bunch of strawberries sliced up.
Mm-hmm.
You want them sliced, so then when you put them against the edge, you'll see that
and
pretty sliced
beautiful
strawberry.
Around the side. Okay.
Then once you've done the edge with the sliced ones, you can also have some chopped up ones, and then you can just put a little small layer in the middle, so then you get some of the strawberries in that middle, the middle of the trifle as well. All right, so you're just gonna repeat those layers. Cake, mousse, strawberry, cake, mousse, strawberry.
Yay. So here it is, you guys. It's beautiful, Emily.
Thank you.
It tastes fantastic, and like I said, Emily brings it to all of our functions that we ask her to. And then you said sometimes you put whipped cream, is that
right?
Yeah,
you can just put some other regular whipped cream for decoration. I put some extra strawberries on top.
Right. It looks fantastic. All right, you guys. I think I'm going to save this for a family dinner later, so we'll see what they say, but they're going to be excited. And Pearl, did you want to have a strawberry? Pearlie, did you want to have a strawberry? You can come have one. Okay, look. There you go. All right, guys. Thanks, Emily. I love
you.
See you guys later.